47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation.
More than two centuries later, a government of the people, by the people, and for the people has not perished from the earth.
That we still believe as Abraham Lincoln did, those who deny freedom to others deserve it not for themselves.
Abraham Lincoln reminded us that a house divided against itself cannot stand.
In a nation that proclaimed liberty and justice for all, too many black Americans were living with neither.
Freedom! Freedom! Freedom!
Gettysburg College has a tremendous opportunity because it stands for the battle for freedom. And so we are conscious of that opportunity that we can address these kinds of questions about freedom and emancipation in very tangible ways.
The name of this place still resonates with a shuddering in the hearts of the American people. And even Americans who aren't sure precisely what transpired on these fields know that all the glory and all the tragedy we associate with the Civil War resides most palpably, most indelibly here.
On our arrival, we found all rooms, halls, and hallways were occupied with the poor, deluded sons of the South. The moans, prayers, and shrieks of the wounded and dying were everywhere. Only a heart dispossessed of all humanity could refuse sympathy and help. Michael Calver, Gettysburg College, class of 1863.
The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom.
I stood within 20 feet of him when he delivered his immortal address. His face was very sad, and his gestures were few, but his voice clear as a silver-toned bell. Thomas Charles Billheimer, Gettysburg College, class of 1865.
I think Lincoln would probably have seen the sacrifice of all those soldiers at Gettysburg, and in particular the loss of Union life. I think he would have seen it as a waste if the nation had just somehow permitted the continued existence of slavery. So I think for Lincoln, there's no other answer, there's no other solution but continue to fight and continue to die until it's resolved.
Abraham Lincoln says that the loss of life is a new birth of freedom. Now, are you going to tell me that the loss of Confederate life here, we should also understand it as a new birth of freedom?
Lincoln had to give people purpose, because if you confront the harsh realities, it's not pretty.
Does Lincoln's Gettysburg Address reaffirm that notion that some Americans have, that through the shedding of blood, we find our true selves as Americans?
Obviously, equality isn't perfect after that, but there's a huge social change, and there's now millions of African Americans that are finally free.
But we need to remind ourselves that for men who had to leave their dead comrades here, who staggered away from Gettysburg, that this moment was not necessarily a new birth of freedom, it was a moment of incredible confusion.
History forces us to acknowledge the limits of memory. It tells us that memory is imperfect, that no matter how much of the past we've recovered, much that once was is lost. And one of the jobs of art is to go to the impossible places that other disciplines like history must avoid. Through art, we enlist the imagination to bring what's lost back to us, to bring the dead back to life.
As a kid, you know, like I was exposed to war violence in Bosnia, and that made an impact. It's my way of looking at the world, understanding it, communicating back with it, you know, through the medium of art, medium of paint. By seeing all those details in those paintings, my hope is you get a sense of the past. You get sense of the life which vanished. You know, like certain things never fade away. They cannot. And war in Bosnia or American Civil War, they make you who you are.
The Battle of Gettysburg and the American Civil War are a huge part of the fabric of this community. And music is such a powerful communicator of stories and feelings and emotion. Gettysburg, the Third Day, is one of the pieces that really tells a powerful story. It literally shows, through the music, the events of that day of battle. When the brass and the woodwinds enter, you can hear the soldiers as they march up Seminary Ridge, and you can then proceed into the full battle. When we're rehearsing music, it's very important that it's not simply playing notes on a page, because I believe that unless you're aware of really the meaning behind a piece, it's very difficult to be a feeling musician and to communicate that to the audience.
Flattened bullets were everywhere in evidence. Not only fragments of shells, but unexploded missiles themselves. For years, there was every now and then a serious casualty, as men and boys ran the risk of opening these dangerous projectiles. Henry Eyster Jacobs, Gettysburg College, class of 1862.
I can appreciate the sacredness of the battlefields. I love history. I think it is important to keep them historically accurate because they do draw so many tourists in who wish to see it, how it was when all the soldiers and armies were here. Obviously, during the battle, it was two sides fighting for things that they believed in, but I think afterwards, it offered a point to learn what we did, because all American lives were lost, North or South, they were Americans. It's a learning point to see what people will go to try to fight for what they believe in and how much tragedy can be caused because of that.
One of the things that I really like about United States history is we were a country that was founded around a set of ideals. And I think the Civil War ultimately was a war to figure out if those ideals were going to actually apply to everybody. And I understand that both Union soldiers and Confederate soldiers thought they were fighting for their vision of what America should be about. But ultimately, the Confederates were fighting for a vision of America that included having black people as property.
Imagine what would have happened if the Civil War had ended because Lee wanted Gettysburg. At the end of the day, what slaves need is freedom. And the only person who can provide that is Lincoln. He must declare them legally free so that they can stand out in the broad sunlight. Let me tell you something. Power is here today and gone tomorrow. But the law is forever.
We here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
Lincoln represents how we want to see ourselves, and we want to see ourselves as people who will do what is right no matter what the circumstances, and that ultimately achieve those ideals that the nation was founded on. However, freedom without other kinds of equalities is severely compromised. And that's what I think we're still struggling to figure out, how we make those legacies of the Civil War manifested in tangible ways today.
Lincoln suggested here at Gettysburg, to try to grasp the meaning of our existence is the great task always before us all. Historians, artists, statesmen, politicians, everyone on earth, to try to comprehend the point of our struggles and our suffering, our defeats, our triumphs. The search for the meaning of our lives and of our deaths is the highest function of our capacities to reason, to remember, to imagine, and to dream.
While over his plain and rugged countenance appeared to settle a great melancholy, it was somehow lightened as by a great hope. As each word was spoken, it appeared to me so clearly fraught with a message, not only for us this day, but for untold generations of men. H.C. Holloway, Gettysburg College, Class of 1861.